All right, hey, it's Larry here, Xbox's Major Nelson. Happy Friday. Welcome to the this edition of the official Xbox podcast. We're doing it live for you right now around the world. Joining me today, let's go to the three shot. Who do I have here? Yes, we do. We got Malik over there, way over there on the left. We got Kelly in the middle, of course, me on the right.
Hi.
Welcome, gang. First of all, we have to apologize. I like starting on time. We're a couple minutes late because Kelly and I were talking about New England. And we're like, we got to go live.
Well, not only that, and I'm just sitting here like, oh, they're talking about New England again. Here we go. And so I'm just listening and talking about Cumberland and all these other towns. I only know Boston. Boston's the only one that I know, the only one that matters. Probably.
Well, for those of you that don't know, Kelly and I are from New England. I'm from Connecticut. Kelly's from Rhode Island. And Malik's from New York.
Yeah, that's probably.
But identifies
what it is.
as a Baltimore.
Maryland.
That's right.
Yeah. Baltimore, not you're
a Terrapin. Yeah.
How do you do that? But anyway, first of all, welcome. We're headed in the U.S. here. We're kind of headed into a holiday week, July 4th, which is the nation's birthday, is Tuesday.
It's a weird one.
Monday's kind of Monday, and so people are kind of off on Monday. So yeah, we're kind of.
It's that holiday that changes the day every year. And so we were talking about it before the show. It's like, if it's like, depending on when it falls in the week, people, you know, kind of take their vacations and adjust it appropriately.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, it's on a Tuesday. So not the best for celebrating, but, you know, we're going to make it work.
I haven't had a chance to talk to you guys since we got back from Showcase a couple weeks ago. I was in Mexico, as we know, because I talked about it last week. You guys were down in L.A. doing the Fan Fest. Looked great. I saw some photos.
Mm-hmm. Kelly was the star of the show.
As always.
I was.
I will say, like, I was definitely a little bit rusty because we did it a little different this year. If you weren't there, all the fans were up in the balcony this year. Last year, we had some fans down, and so, like, on the floor, and so we had to look up, and I felt like that threw me off a little bit.
But right.
Kelly had it on point. We got to interact with fans. It was awesome.
Why? Then, because she went up there? Why does she have it on point?
I think Kelly's just a pro. And she's
Should we ask her about
confident.
It? She's
yeah.
here.
Yeah, Kelly. Oh, Kelly.
Oh, hello.
I'm giving you your flowers, Kelly, to your face.
Well, I know that this is my opportunity to say, like, oh, no, it was all Malik. But no, I'm going to take my flowers.
Yay.
And no, it was a lot of fun. And I think that, like, Malik and I have done that kind of event together a few times now. And so there were times where, like, he would forget a line and kick it to me. And I would be like, oh, yep, here we are. And then same when I would be like, oh, I feel like a stutter coming on, or like, I'm losing my train of thought. I would just be like, and Malik, and he'd just pick up right where I left off. Yeah. So it's always really great doing that.
And Larry, you kind of know what Kelly, you know, was just talking about as far as like when you have like rapport and like chemistry with a host, like you can rely on them to pick up when you are not maybe at the top of your game and then vice versa. So I think it just works. Mm-hmm. It was great seeing all the fans there. I do want to say we played this game called, what was it called? FanFest Feud. And kind of funny.
Oh, man, they ripped you guys on it.
They showed us, because Jeff Keighley put a tweet out. It was like, hey, I'm watching them play FanFest Feud. And kind of funny, live on the air, was like, they're ripping us off. So I'm here to say kind of funny.
By the way,
I love you guys, but.
By the way, I got to tell you something. I'm really bummed out because I don't know if you know this. Maybe you do know this. But, like, I have always wanted to be a game show host. And so when I was doing FanFest, like, they didn't have the games. Now they bring in the games. Like, I've got the microphone. Have you ever seen my microphone?
Yeah, I have. The long one. Yeah,
the big Bob Barker microphone. Yeah. So I'm like, what's up, fan? So anyway, we got to figure that out. I want to come do that with you guys. But, but
it was a lot of fun. I got a notification on Twitter that was like, oh, Kelly and I made it on to Kind of Funny Games Daily. And I was so pumped. I was like, wow, bucket list item. And then I saw that they were threatening us with a lawsuit. And I was like, oh, this went in a direction I would have not imagined in a million years.
Your tweet, ..
Yeah, it was another your tweet moment. It was a lot of fun, though. Shout out to those guys. And please don't actually sue us.
Anyway, but it's but we're here. We're gonna hang out with you guys. It's currently 6 minutes after the hour, wherever you are. We are gonna be hanging out with you for a little bit. We got some news. We're gonna talk about what we're playing. We have an interview. Jeff, who's not here, did an interview that we're gonna roll a little bit later on. So we got some cool stuff. We also look at these. Can you see this right here? Not this one.
Yeah, get that one out of here.
This is the Starfield controller and the headset. And I know we can't zoom in on it. But we have two of these, and you're like, wow, I'd love to win those. Well, guess what? You can. But guess what? You can't do it here. After the show, I'm going to be giving away on my Twitter, at Major Nelson, on Xbox Free Code Friday.
World famous, weekly trending superstar Major Nelson. Follow him for that I haven't seen these in person. This is my first time.
Hey, Kelly.
Just trying to get some profit, a discount. I did want to just give a shout out to chat. I know we are live. I promise you. I see all your unbox with Josh. We got like Maddie, Matt.
Yeah. Why would they not think we're live?
I don't know. You know, you ever watch something that's live to tape and you don't like because they don't acknowledge anything that happens. You don't know if it's actually live. We're actually live. Yeah. I swear.
Drop it in the chat and I'll read it.
There you go.
That's dangerous.
not any of it, but some of it.
A select comment. Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah,
we're so cool.
We're gonna give those away later on. Free Code Friday. Follow me at Major Nelson, and we'll. And you could win them. We're also giving away. We're giving away the wrestling game. What's it called?
AEW Fight Forever.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We should see. Would you like to play it?
Sure. Sure.
So
I'll beat you guys up.
Mike Rowley. I don't know why you said PlayStation, but okay.
Wow.
I guess they want to prove that we were live.
Yeah.
Yo, Malik, looking one fine man today. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Aww.
I brushed my beard or my whatever this is called. Mustache.
Goatee.
I brushed it today.
Just a quick note. We are streaming this on my Twitter handle, on YouTube. But if you want to win, you want to join the chat, head over twitch.tv/Xbox. We're on the big channel there. So hopefully you can join us and swing by the chat. But we're squirting this out. Can I say that?
Yeah.
To a bunch of different channels. Yeah, she says with a look, with a look of panic.
I don't make the rules here.
Yeah, exactly.
Can I say this? Well, we're live, so you did.
I want to point
this just in.
I want to point something out. You know, we talked about Showcase, which was a few weeks ago, but you know, Malik and I work on more of the communications, tell the stories. But Kelly, you actually work on a lot of games. But one of the games mm-hmm. that you worked on was revealed at Showcase, right?
It was.
Can we roll the tape on that just to remind people, and you can explain to people about what it is?
Yeah, I would love that. I am really excited to bring Towerborn to the masses. So this is a game that I personally have been working on for a few years and has been in development for years. It's by the team at Stoic who created the Banner Saga. And, you know, you can read, they did an interview on Xbox Wire that was really interesting, that goes in depth on like the gameplay and lore a little bit, but they called the Banner Saga Depression Simulator because it's a narrative experience and it's very like, you know, it's got some heavy themes and it's kind of like sad. And so when they came out of that, they were like, all right, if we could make any game, what would we want to make? And they took a step back and they were like, we want to make something bright and hopeful and fun to play. Something that's really approachable.
And that's what you're seeing on your screen right now.
So it's co-op, so you can play with up to four people at a time. Console has local co-op. Console and PC have online co-op. And you can change the difficulty setting at any time. So if you want to kind of just like jump in, bop around and play a little bit, complete some missions, you can. If you want to like go for that like hardcore grind, you can up the difficulty and play. You can see
Towerborn.
There's like a world map with tiles. And so you kind of like wander out of the tower onto the world map, and then you can choose a level and great. Like load in, and yeah, it's a lot of fun. So check it out. And we're actually having people sign up for the Insiders program right now.
Yep.
So if you want access to early builds, giving feedback, exclusive news, go to towerborn.com, sign up today.
Yeah. All right.
And I will say, like, going back to Showcase a little bit, for the second year, Kelly and I sat together when we were watching the show.
Yeah.
And last year it was As Dusk Falls, and this year it was really cool seeing her get excited for
Towerborn. So you hadn't seen it prior to that, right?
No.
You saw it with everybody else.
Yeah, yeah. I saw it for the first time, but it was exciting seeing Kelly like, oh, my game's about to come. And I was like really excited. It was just really cool to see see Kelly working on a game and get really excited for it.
Same thing with Forza. Like, we would look at each other and be like, okay, mine's next. Yeah. And then we would like get excited. And Martin, who on the comms team, was actually taking photos of the event. And he has a really cool photo of Malik and I both looking up going, like little kids, like looking up at the screen, like it's Christmas.
I'll take a look at that. And speaking of Forza, you did a little bit of work on Forza, right?
Yeah, Forza Motorsport coming out this October. Really excited about it. It is a stunning looking game. It's a Forza Motorsport game, so you know, top level of visuals. But the team has gone in and reworked so much. It's going to be the most realistic Forza ever. I'm so sure of it. Go on news.xbox.com. You can catch up with all that they're doing on there on the new game. And I work on the creator team, and so we You know, it's one thing for Xbox to say something. It's a whole different thing for a creator who loves cars, loves video games, loves fidelity in video games to kind of showcase. And so we work with iJustine.
I want to point out what you just said, because you work on the creator team. And that's just so people at home may say, oh, that Malik, you're a creator. Well, yeah, Malik is a creator. But we actually have a whole team of people that works with other creators to tell them to make sure that they're armed with the right information to talk about our games. Like you did with how is Justine? I haven't seen her forever.
She's great. She was actually here. We filmed her thing
in this building back
in April, and it was her first time here. And so anytime someone comes to the studio, because what you all see here is only one studio,
so we're like, so should I explain
it? Go for it.
We have this special studio in a secret location here in the Seattle area, and it's so when you see, like when you saw Phil come on stage or Sarah come on stage with a beautiful background, that's actually downstairs in a set. It's all dark right now because it's not being used. It's got dust covers and everything. We're kind of like in the attic. We're in this
a very beautiful attic.
Yeah, beautiful attic, but it's a smaller version of that studio. We don't get to use that studio because it requires like 50 people to get audio and sound. We have just a team, a couple people in our stream over here. They're great. They do great. But it's great to be in that building. So it's great to have that we had her in the building. You brought the cars in too.
We had the cars on stage, which I didn't think it would hold up the cars, but we had two cars on stage. We had some amazing shots. If you go to iJustine's YouTube channel, you can check out the video. We had a shot where she was in the car. We put the little unveiling tarp over it and had a fan blow it off the car. So there's just that, you know, this team, both the team up here and the team that works downstairs in the studio, just world class, and it's really cool. And so I'm excited about Forza Motorsport, and we have a few things before launch that we're excited to talk about. So
yeah. Anyway, we're just, if you're joining us right now, first of all, welcome. If you're watching this on Twitter, my YouTube or Facebook or anywhere else, head over to twitch.tv/Xbox. We're dropping some codes in. Some of them work, some of them don't. Apparently, according to the chat. There we go. Oh, it's missing characters. So we'll fix it. We'll fix it. Anyway.
Well, okay. Yeah. So I'll explain the way it works in the chat a little bit.
Please do.
Yeah. They're dropping a code in the chat, and there's going to be one character missing. And that is to prevent bots from like auto farming codes that we give away. So, you have to
you human
all of my little human beings in the chat, you guys go and redeem the code and try to guess the missing character.
We usually put a clue.
There's usually a clue, and so that's how you get it.
I'm so glad we fixed that, because I used to do that years ago. And like, I would always get a nasty gram from the web team whether you redeem it, because they're like, no, because basically I'm DDoSing the service. You know? Mm-hmm. Everyone's hammering it, but we now have it with Azure and all the rest of this stuff. It's not protected. Everything works great. So I'm glad that we worked it. Thank you, humans. Thank you, chat humans.
Yeah.
Thank you, human beings.
Thank you, human beings. You got some news over there, don't you, my friend? You got some other stuff to talk
it's
about?
Been a kind of a light news week, but I did want to call attention to, honestly, one of my favorite games this generation, and I bet y'all can't guess what it is. It's not Apex. Apex is my favorite game, but it's one of my favorite games.
What is it?
City Skylines?
That is also City Skylines 2, Xbox Game Pass this year. Cannot wait, but it's not that. We're talking about Microsoft Flight Sim, which is a game that I play just when I want to get away a little bit.
Where do you go?
Oh, I go
Tell me about your flight path.
One of my favorite things that I've ever done was fly in a little Cessna over Italy, very low to the buildings. And the game, if you haven't played Flight Sim, if you don't think it's for you, I promise you, just give it a shot. You can pick an easy plane like a Cessna, but you can literally fly over these cities that are recreated in stunning detail. And so I would go in Italy, and I would just fly really low over the buildings. It is stunning.
Do me a favor. Don't land at the Colosseum and scratch your name in the side of the Colosseum.
I won't. Like although I
see this story?
No.
This guy,
a real thing?
Somebody over in Italy, I saw it pop up in the news this week. Like he was he and his girlfriend's name into the side of the Colosseum, this 2,000-year-old building. Not cool, dude.
Wait, in real life?
Yes. And apparently they found out who he is, and he's in big trouble.
Well, yeah, because his name, he put his name on the side of the building. But they couldn't catch him. I feel like that would be a problem.
But go look about this. I'm like, dude, first of all, it's the Colosseum. It's the Roman Colosseum.
Unbelievable. Okay. Well, almost as nice as Italy, Texas. you know, no shade to anyone from Texas.
Of the United States.
Right.
Yeah, it's the second largest state, according to Xbox Newswire, in the country. And so basically what Microsoft Flight Sim does is they will regularly do these world updates where they go into a specific...
World update.
World update.
World update.
I like that. I like that. I like that better, actually. And they'll make updates. They'll add detail to individual areas. And so this newest one was announced on the 29th, so yesterday. And it's going to be Texas. And so they're going in and recreating Abilene, Austin, Cedar Park, San Antonio, Schertz, Temple, and Waco. And so if you are a fan, and here we have a picture.
Look at the rainbow.
It looks amazing. This is...
Where is that?
This is,
look at that.
Random Texas city with buildings and parking lot. Maybe Houston, let's say it's Houston. Why not?
It looks too small.
Let us know. But yeah, so you can go in, download a new world update, and I promise you. By the way, speaking of the Xbox Game Showcase, Microsoft Flight Sim 2024 was announced, and that was one of those that I was super excited about because you can now do jobs in that game. Such as VIP charter service. I've always wanted to charter. Ooh.
You can take me someplace. Celeb.
Oh, is it going to be you're the VIP? All right.
Kelly, you can be the VIP too.
Yeah.
You can take us back to New England. You can take it to New England.
Gladly.
Yeah.
Duncan Run.
We're going to Cumberland.
But yeah, so we have a few, you know, so keep up to date, news.xbox.com. There's a few other stories, but it's been kind of a light news week. We're coming off of the Xbox.
Can I talk about the fact that they're putting the Stratoliner in? The 307, the flight sim is putting the 307.
Oh.
Boeing Stratoliner, and I am so Ooh. Excited about that. Nerd.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite airplane?
No.
I do.
What's yours?
See? Well, it was a Boeing 747. They are no longer in service, but they are like the double decker. Well, they're in service, but just not in the U.S. Double decker plane, massive plane.
Can I tell you, I've flown on them a few times.
Have you?
Not only have I flown on one, but I'll never forget the strangest flight I ever had. I went from Japan to. Where did I go? Amsterdam.
Oh, nice.
And it was a cargo plane where the whole front flips
just
up.
Opens and they put the cargo
in. They put the cargo in the back. They put it down, and we sat in the front.
That's so cool.
On the upstairs.
That's so cool.
It was bananas.
So that's my favorite plane, but one of my favorite planes, but 737s. And I actually like Airbuses as well. All the plane nerds are like excited about this, and everyone else is like, what are they, 737, 747? It's a plane thing.
I like a seaplane.
Okay.
What does that mean? What's a seaplane?
What do you mean? Oh, it's like plane with the thing,
letter C. No, I was like, what is that?
No.
No, I get it. Yeah, they fly. We see them a lot here in Seattle.
Yeah. We actually have one of the only seaplane airports in the country, if I recall correctly.
I watched one land on a lake while I was having lunch the other day. It was beautiful.
One of my favorite airplanes is, and I don't think it's in, the Boeing Clipper, which is one of the first long. One of the first aircraft that would go long range to like Asia.
Oh, nice.
Would stop in Hawaii. Anyway, take a look at those. It was pretty. What are you laughing at?
SpongeBob in chat goes, they're called boats, Kelly.
Actually, no. So the Cockney Turf says Indiana Jones Raiders of the Lost Ark. That's the seaplanes. But what's funny is in Indiana Jones, there's also, remember when they go through the map? That's the Clipper that's going to the different places.
So
both of our favorite planes are in Indiana Jones.
What's Indiana Jones?
Okay, there we go.
It's different. If we're talking about boats, my favorite boat is a duck boat.
Quack, quack.
Okay.
Quack. But no, it's awesome.
We're off the rails. You got to get back.
We're so off the rails.
This is an Xbox podcast.
Yeah, I don't know what happened here. I'm sorry.
It's okay. We
get back to
what we love. Yeah, let's talk about
what are you playing, Malik?
We're playing Apex. You know me, Apex Legends. Although I will say I'm getting prepared. You know, we're less than, I don't even know how to do the math, but we're getting really close to Starfield. And so I am not committing to any new games. I played Planet Alana. I haven't finished it yet. I know you all talked about it on the show recently.
Yep.
So I'll finish that. But before Starfield, I'm keeping my plate clean, sticking with Apex Legends because September, I'm going to get early access. So September 1st. Starfield all day, every day.
Good. Kelly, what are you playing right now?
Diablo is life.
Okay, Diablo.
I have been having so much fun with it. Anytime I have a free moment, I load it up, I jump in, I play. I still haven't finished.
Ooh.
Ooh.
What? Oh, yeah, wow. Here we go. Keep going. We're listening.
I started with a rogue. And switch to a sorceress. So both characters are over level 50. I've just been doing a bunch of side quests.
I love how you're so distracted by the trailer.
I am.
Keep your thoughts straight.
I also love Halsey. So I also, she did the
song. Should we stop this so you can focus?
Kind of.
There we go.
I love the song that Halsey did for it. And then I was thinking, I think I talked, I don't know if it was on this podcast, but you know.
How many other podcasts are you on?
Oh, hundreds.
Are you being promiscuous on?
I'm stepping out on the Xbox podcast. You know, I'm booked and busy, major. So I was talking about how it would be like a career highlight for me. You know, when we did the live E3 shows, when they would have like songs that would play, like almost like baseball players, like your walkout song.
Oh, your walkout song, yeah.
And I always said that mine would be You Should See Me in a Crown by Billie Eilish. And then Diablo used it for their trailer, and it just was full.
Wait, so that was Billie Eilish?
Yeah.
Okay, because I was gonna say that, but then you said Halsey, and I was like, oh, good thing I didn't say that.
No, I was thinking of like Halsey did the Lilith song for it, but that was Billie Eilish.
Billie Eilish is amazing. If you all don't listen to Billie Eilish, she has one of the best voices. Anyway, sorry, didn't mean that.
Yeah.
Just wanted to sidetrack Diablo.
Diablo's great. Play it if you haven't. I can't stop, won't stop. But I have also been playing. So every morning, I'm still one of those people. Let me know in chat if you can relate. I'm still one of those people that play Wordle every day. Mm. So I log into I'm the one guy. Every morning, I log in to play my word game. So I do Wordle, I do the mini crossword on New York Times, and I do the crossword puzzle. Usually crossword is like Mondays, Tuesdays, because then it starts getting hard.
So you're doing the mini crosswords or the big ones?
Yeah, both.
Okay.
So I try to do mini crosswords in under a minute. That's
you know
how
you learned all those words, right? You learned them from reading.
Listen. I just appreciate the producers.
Ever heard of it?
He doesn't read books.
Thank you.
I love that.
The silence after you said that is so turn.
Unbelievable.
As Malik just turtles into himself.
I'm proud of not reading.
Okay, so there's a new New York Times game that
I'm looking at it right here. Tell them about it.
And it's called Connections. And so it's not in the app. It's in beta. So it's on the...
As opposed to Missed Connections.
Yes. That's a different app that I'm on. So the Connections beta, and it's a new word game. And basically you have to group words that share a common thread. So it looks like this. You might be able to see it on my screen a little bit. And basically it's just a bunch of words, and there are four groups, and you have to select the words that are associated with each other, but they can be tricky, right? Like, so sometimes you'll see words that are all like foods or something like that, but one might belong to a different group because it can be classified as two different things. So you get four chances. So when you guess, like,
I'm playing it right now.
Yeah, when you guess what's like grouped together.
It's kind of cool.
No spoilers. What? Oh my God, I haven't played it yet today. But you get chances. And so if you select a group and it's not right, it'll tell you how many away you are from being correct. And then you'll get a strike. And so if you run out of chances, then you lose. But if you group them all before you run out of chances, you win. So, yeah. For me, it's super fun. It gets my brain going. Yeah. Every morning I get up, I make my coffee, and I do my little word games, and that's a new one for me. So it's not on Xbox, but it's on New York Times. Good job.
My very first one. Great.
Yeah.
So, okay, that was fun.
And purple is supposed to be the trickiest.
Oh, I nailed it.
Grouping. So it goes like purple, blue, green, yellow. Uh-oh. And so, yeah, good job.
It's all with words.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
You gotta know the words.
You gotta know words. You have to be able to read the words.
Listen, I can read. I promise you. Somebody asked, like, does Malik read his scripts? No. I just guess what's on the teleprompter. Of course I read scripts. I am an amazing reader. I just want to say that.
This doesn't read books.
I just choose not to do it because it's boring.
I don't know. I never saw him read his cards for FanFest. He just asked a lot. Yeah,
that's why I was like, Kelly?
Yeah.
That's why he was throwing it to you.
What it was, yeah.
See earlier conversation.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
Yep.
Anyway,
what
sorry.
About you? Oh, sorry.
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
I finished Jedi. Which I really enjoyed. Yeah. It was a little bit longer. There's a lot of twists and turns and fun at the end there. So did that. Here we go. It's this is a lot of fun. So I did that one. It was fun because I got to, you know, finish it and play it till the end and then watch the credits. I love watching credits because I love looking at people that I used to work with or know. Which is always a fun thing to do with a lot of different games. So because I've been doing this for so long, and you guys will find this out. as you, the more you're in the industry, that, you know, a lot of your friends and coworkers will go work at other companies. Mm-hmm. And it just increases your web of your connective web.
Connective web. I love that. Now, I have a question on this game.
Yeah.
As someone who didn't play Fallen Order but wants to jump into this one, how is it? Is it difficult?
There is a story mode that you can play, and it's manageable. It's not that difficult.
The
characters, I think the characters are really good.
Yeah.
This is the first time I came across the Rancor, and I was like, what do I do here? That one took a while. but it was, this is the trailer. This isn't me playing. And it was really a lot of fun. And the world, to be, you know, we all love, a lot of us love the Star Wars world. So being able to play in this universe and feel like a Jedi was just so incredible. So I just I highly recommend it.
Love that.
Are you a Star Wars fan, Kelly? I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Star Wars is cool. I have...
Ask me to name 5 Star Wars characters right now.
No, I'm not going to do that. Name 6.
That's so funny. No, I and I haven't watched a Star Wars, so you're probably far ahead of me, Kelly. I have not watched a Star Wars movie. My second favorite game of all time, though, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic.
Of course, KOTOR.
KOTOR. Yeah. One of the best Xbox games of all time.
Yeah, but it was, anyway, so that, playing that, Halo still with the latest update, it's been a lot of fun to go back in there and play Infection, which is fun. They got some new stuff going on there, a couple new maps. They actually have another map coming up next week. Have you guys played Infection in Halo?
I have not. I feel like we should have played this after the show. I haven't played Halo in so long, but I am waiting for the right time to jump back in, and maybe this is the right time because people were so pumped for this, and I need to go back and play. What about you, Kelly?
Yeah, I've played Infection in
back in the day.
Back in the day,
right.
But not in this new update, but I'm excited to see it here. It's always fun when they bring back some fan favorites and integrate them in with new gameplay. So I love it.
Yeah. So I've been playing that. And then I also have been playing a little bit of Diablo. Phil and I were trying to play together the other night, but he's way, Phil Spencer. He's so far ahead of me. And I was just like,
name drop.
Oh, yeah.
What?
What a name drop. I was playing with Phil Spencer.
Well, it's funny.
I was playing with my friend Phil. You may have heard of him.
He and I were in a party together, and he's like, oh, you want to play? And I was just about, I'm like, look, I really want to finish Jedi. Mm-hmm. So let me go. I dumped out of the party. Do you guys, when you're playing with friends online, do you feel like you stay in the party if you're playing 2 different games? Chat, let us know. Like, what do you do if you want to hang out with your friends? Do you stay in the chat? If you're not playing the same game, obviously you're playing the same game. You want to communicate. How do you roll? Malik.
I don't have friends, so.
Right. Okay.
I'm just kidding. I've done that where you play 2 separate games. It doesn't work when, again, as someone plays Apex, that doesn't work because I would like to communicate with my team. And so more often than not, I'll say like, hey, I'll dip out and meet up with you all later. So,
right.
Yeah.
That's kind of what I want to do because he was playing with some other folks. And I just didn't want to.
Yeah.
I kind of wanted to focus because it's a story mode. So you want to focus on that. Sorry, Phil. Later. Click. Exit party.
Whoa.
What?
Wow.
He was fine with it. He's cool. He's cool. What about you, Kelly? When you're playing, do you play different games when you're in a party with your friends, or do you just party up when you're playing a multiplayer game like Apex or something?
It depends. I would say a mix of both. Like it's difficult sometimes when you're playing 2 different things, but sometimes if you're just like zoning out on a game and it doesn't, you know, it's not story driven and you're just kind of like going through the motions. Like if I'm playing House Flipper and there's not a lot of like sound involved, but I'm just kind of doing it. It is a great way to catch up with friends.
Oh, yeah, of course.
A lot of friends like all over the country. And so it's nice, you know, like catch up when you're not able to see each other in person.
Yep.
Ketchup and mustard. You know, so we should do...
Are you saying that because of my sweater?
Oh, no, but that is a... He said ketchup, and so I made a stupid joke. But I will say, you know what, Larry, since you have a connection with Phil, and there's 3 of us here, maybe you should introduce... I don't know, Kelly, I don't know if you want to talk about our Phil story at FanFest, but we should...
Please. Well, you have to now.
Oh, with the camera where we were taking a picture?
Kelly doesn't look like she wants to say it.
Listen to how this man embarrassed me.
Oh no.
So we're backstage at FanFest and
down in LA.
Uh-huh. And Phil, Malik and I were hosting, but the leadership team and Phil and Aaron always do a really great job of like showing up and connecting.
They're your opening act.
Yeah. So Phil went out and you know, did his intro, and when he came back, I was like, ooh, do you think we can ask him for a photo? Mm-hmm. And Malik was like, oh, I'm too scared. You have to do it. And I was like, oh, I'll do it. but like, you're going to be in the picture with us. He was like, yeah, okay, please. Yeah, please. Oh my gosh, Kelly, I'm just so scared. You would be my hero if you asked him for a photo that we would treasure forever.
Wow. That sounds like Malik. That sounds exact. Go ahead.
Yeah. So I'm like, okay, all right. Like, you don't have to be shy. I'll be the hero. And so I go up to Phil and I was like, Phil, hey, like, you know, we had already like chatted with him before. I was like, do you mind if we get a photo before you go? He was like, oh, absolutely. So I go to hand him my phone and Malik goes, no, my phone's better than hers. And he pulls mine back and hands Phil his. And Phil was like, oh, okay. And like, you know, someone else backstage took the picture of us. But I was like, after all of that, I was the one that had the courage to like ask for a photo and do this. And then he goes, oh no, her phone's garbage. Use mine instead. And I was like,
well, I was gonna
apologize.
How are
you gonna do me like that?
I was gonna apologize for that up until the point where you misrepresented my thoughts about asking Phil about calling you a hero and that I was too scared. I was just like, I don't wanna be the person. But no, it was awesome. And the picture's on social, but yeah. Phil's cool, so maybe we should all four of us, maybe we should get him on the podcast and we'll play him.
He's been busy.
Yeah, that's true.
That's just that's an understatement. Anyway, all right. So that's kind of what I'm playing. hey chat, if you're joining us wherever you are right now, if you're watching us on Twitter, YouTube, or Facebook, swing by twitch.tv/Xbox. That's where that's the chat we've got up here in the studio. Let us know what you're playing, or frankly, what you're going to be playing this weekend, because we're going into the weekend, regardless of where you are. It is the weekend.
Yeah.
Right?
That's right.
That's how time works.
Well, right now it's like halfway through the weekend down in Australia. What do you got there, Malik? Yeah.
Oh, no, just I love, like, you were talking about the weekend, and I was going to say, like, this is my time for fast food. And Javer in chat was like, surprise, Malik isn't talking about McDonald's yet. Like, almost.
Are you doing that grimace thing?
What
was that for?
Have you seen the grimace trend?
Yes.
I would love to see Malik do that.
No. Okay. So for those who don't know, McDonald's has they have these, like, meals that they come out with that are related to celebrities or folks of some sort of infamy, and they have Grimace, who is this beast. I don't know what Grimace is, but apparently he left and he came back and he loves chicken nuggets. But point being, arbitrarily, it's his birthday, and you know, so they came out with this meal, which the meal is usually just something that's already on the menu, except for a shake. This shake is purple in color, and apparently, as people have described it to me, it is a vanilla shake with a hint of berry. And so if you haven't seen online, there's been a Grimace Shake challenge where the point of these videos is that, hey, we're going to try this new Grimace Shake. I spit on you. Sorry. I apologize.
It's okay.
But
you could buy me a Grimace Shake to make up for it.
Maybe you don't want it after you hear this.
Well, so the challenge is people will try the Grimace Shake and then it turns them into, it's almost like a zombifies them.
Yeah.
It, you know, it turns them into this.
It's called an ice cream headache. Let's be clear.
And so I would love to try it, and maybe Malik from 10 years ago would have. But now I just think about how much sugar is. Like, I saw a video of how much sugar is in the milkshake, and if they pour it, like, the sugar in there, it's like half the cup. Right. So I don't know. If I can try it.
Geyser says if anyone does the Grimace trend, it should be Malik, not Kelly. He has a better phone after all.
Oh, that's right. You know, I have a friend of mine who used to work at McDonald's, the corporate McDonald's, and they worked in HR.
Nice.
And you know what they used to call that person? The Grimace Reaper.
Oh.
Oh.
Take care of business. I like that.
The take care of business.
There it is again. Ooh, that's a tough one to get, and I got it twice on the show.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you want to see us do the Grimace Challenge, all three of us, maybe we'll do it in the very
I am
future.
Not doing the Grimace Challenge.
No? Okay, well, then.
100K likes on Twitter. We'll do the Grimace Challenge.
I'm not doing that. Anyway, all right, so it's almost lunchtime.
That's right.
I know.
At least it here is out here on the West Coast, on the East Coast. They're getting ready for the coffee break.
That's right.
Speaking of coffee break, we're going to take a moment here and go in. Jeff had an interview about one of his favorite games and some DLC going. So why don't we go ahead and listen to that, and we'll come back on the other side and play some games.
I'm a huge fan of escape rooms. I'll have you know, I have solved more than 20 different escape rooms. Bit of a caveat here, about half of those, maybe more, were virtual through a game called Escape Academy. It's part of Xbox Game Pass, and I have to tell you, it is one of my favorite co-op games of the generation. Escape Academy's second DLC, Escape from the Past, it's out now, and here to talk with us is Wyatt Bushnell, co-founder of the developers of Escape Academy. They're called Coin Crew Games. Wyatt, thanks so much for joining us. How things going, man?
Oh, you know, chugging along. Thanks for having me. Yeah, just there's nothing like a launch to really get the blood flowing.
No doubt. And DLC. And, you know, this has been an incredibly exciting game because I will say it's my daughter was not old enough to do an escape room, at least the ones around here, when the game came out. And so we did that. And since then, she's gone and she crossed that threshold and she's done some in real life. And it sort of developed a love here, which I think is awesome. And let's back up a little bit. I'd love to talk with you or hear from you about the genesis of the game, Escape Rooms. They've been big for some time, but we really haven't seen them translate into video games, which was a huge opportunity, I feel like. There's any direction you could have gone, but I feel like you kind of are like, you know, realistic, but then just a little bit past that. So tell us about how Escape Academy came about.
Yeah, so basically the main inception for the game was we used to build arcade games and escape rooms in like the real world, and then the pandemic hit, and so we basically had to like pivot the entire studio into doing a digital game because that's all we could do because everything was locked down. And so when we were looking at like, hey, what sort of game should we make? We looked online and there were a lot of games that had like kind of one-off, like a single room experience that was maybe like 20 or 30 minutes, but there wasn't one that was like a substantial bite at the apple. And we're like, well, we've done a lot of escape rooms. And what we'd really like being in the pandemic is, hey, I'd love to be able to like play an escape room with my partner. On the couch in co-op or with my nephew or niece. And we didn't really think that was like a market that was being met. And so that's where Escape Academy came from.
Yeah, it totally makes sense. There's a lot of things we missed during the pandemic, and there were games like Flight or simulators like Flight Simulator that made, you know, reenacted all the joys of flying and things going places I couldn't go. And this was one of those things that I think you really tapped into something cool. So I got a question for you. What makes a perfect escape room, in your opinion?
Huh. Okay. God, do I have to pick one thing?
Like, no, what are some of the elements of when you think of like a really good escape room? What are some of the commonalities, perhaps?
Yeah, I think it's like you need to have a lot of like narrative and puzzle cohesion in the room. Like I think like whenever we were building a room, we wanted three things. Like we wanted a threat because we felt the timer was really necessary. And so like we wanted there to be some narrative reason for why you had to get out of the room in 25 minutes, because we thought the pressure, like puzzle solving pressure, was really important to the escape room experience. Two, I think it's like making sure that the puzzles all fit within the theme of the room. And so the sort of the example I give a lot is like in our computer lab level, we have a lot more computer science based puzzles where you're doing like binary operations and that sort of stuff, like you're hacking and that sort of thing. And in our art classroom level, there are a lot of like perspective based puzzles where you have to like look at art and decipher art through that. And so I think like one thing we didn't like like doing escape rooms out of the world is like you're in the Egyptian pharaoh tomb and you have to like, I don't know, link up a power cable or like a magic gem to get power. Like we want to make sure there's a lot of cohesion between what you're doing and what the theme of the room is.
So there were some really fun takes. You talked about sort of that pressure and, you know, the pressure was applied in some levels where the room is filling with water. I really loved that one. Or one where you're poisoned and you need to find the antidote before you die, which that's pretty compelling pressure. And there was a couple that were also different, like you were helping someone else infiltrate and escape from some place, and you were in a control room at one point, which was a really interesting take on these. I'm just curious, like how many rooms like did you all design, and then and how did you sort of narrow it down into the ones that did make the cut for the game?
You know, it's kind of a complicated question because like I think there are a lot of rooms that we developed and scrapped. I think we, you know, we don't actually, we don't develop rooms and scrap the room. We more develop puzzles and scrap the puzzle. But what's nice is like we have this like kind of essentially puzzle graveyard where that we're like constantly revisiting and grave digging to pull puzzles out that fit better in another subsequent room, which has been a fun part of doing these DLCs. Is there a lot of puzzles that we didn't think made sense for a particular room, but made sense in the DLC? Yeah, but I don't think we scrapped a ton of rooms in general.
So that makes sense. You have a series of
a lot of evolutions. Yeah.
Yeah. So, all right. Well, if you're like me, you're gonna play this game. You're gonna jam through the set of 10-ish puzzles in the main game that's part of Game Pass. And now there's DLCs. There's additional content. Like, you're gonna want more. There's more. So first DLC, Escape from Anti-Escape Island, was sort of like based off of like a field trip that goes horribly wrong for the attendees of this academy. Tell us about Escape from the Past, the one that just came out this week.
Yeah, so you know, I think my favorite part about going from coin-op to like arcade games to digital games is just sort of the user feedback that we've been able to get as we not only release the base game and then also release Anti-Escape Island, being able to like take in that feedback to like improve upon our formula. And so, you know, I think Escape from the Past is like, we definitely went way over budget on Escape from the Past, which is bad for us, great for the player. And so it's five rooms, but you're basically playing a murder mystery throughout those five rooms. So there was one thing that, a lot of players kept asking for, which is just sort of like a deeper narrative, and more connective tissue around the rooms. And so this is sort of one of the ways that we wanted to deliver on that. And so it's a very narratively heavy pack, in that you're basically moving through these levels and you're in the past, like you're in the academy of yesteryear, and like a murder attempt happens. And so you're basically, your goal is to determine who the murderer is, and it's one of the teachers. So each room, you're basically piecing together this this greater case, and then the final level is sort of this like Phoenix Wright style trial. That we're really proud of this pack.
Awesome. So full game, two DLCs. Is that a wrap? You know, some teams might say, okay, it's time to work on something else here. Do you have more things planned for Escape Academy?
Yeah, so we have one more update planned. It's the Tournament of Puzzles, which is basically our like player versus player free update. So basically you and someone else can like compete racing through these procedurally generated levels. And so it's like, I think, you know, one of the things that we wanted to do with all like both Escape from the Past and this free update is sort of change like the game that you're playing, rather than giving just more of the same and like the content that we're really stoked about. We wanted to sort of upgrade and change the sort of play format. And so this is how we're sort of trying to do that.
Very cool. Well, can't wait to try that out, and as well as Escape from the Past. That is our plan for the weekend. Y'all know if I go in on a game like this, like Yakuza or Planet of Lana, I am not steering you wrong. Definitely check out Escape Academy. It's on Game Pass for PC and for console. You can play it on split screen. If you've got a friend, awesome couch co-op. You end up finding out who's good at what. And so again, some of my best memories so far this generation. So I want to thank you for that, Wyatt Bushnell, both for creating an awesome game along with your team and for joining us here today.
No, thank you guys so much for having me. We're really excited for people to play this pack and the game in general. So give it a whirl.
All right. Thank you, Jeff. And thank you, Wyatt. It's always good to have Jeff on the show when he's not here, I guess.
Well, I was going to say,
he's always here.
always omnipresent. I was going to say, he stole my what I was going to say coming out of this at the end, where you always can tell when Jeff really loves a game by his intro and then how, like, into it he is.
Oh, yeah.
And just like Yakuza and all those other games, like, Jeff won't lead.
Here's
you
a funny little note that Jeff, I told Jeff beforehand, but it really wasn't relevant to the interview, but I want to just provide a little bit of background. So Wyatt Bushnell, do you know his dad?
Who's his dad?
His dad is Nolan Bushnell, who invented the Atari 2600.
Ooh.
And I've met his dad quite a few times.
Runs in family.
It runs in family. But it's a lot of people. I mean, it's not something, obviously, it had nothing to do with the interview, but it's just like, let's just talk about some of the legacy here.
Yeah.
And it's just fascinating.
We love generational gamers.
Do you?
That's right.
Yeah.
Like, my daughter may be a gamer. I don't know.
Yeah. My dad is the one that got me into video games. I used to read the guide for Tomb Raider to him as he would play.
Oh, nice.
Back when, like, Tomb Raider was really difficult, and it would be like, okay, jump forward 2 spaces, then shimmy left 2, and then jump backwards, and then you'll be on a secret cliff.
Right.
And so I used to sit, and I would have a little light, and I would read him the strategy guide as he would maneuver.
No, Dad, no.
Yeah.
Did you ever just grab the controller and do it for him?
No.
That's awesome. Yeah, those great memories that you share with your family. I love that. And so it's great to see, you know, that kind of being passed down. My dad was like, stop playing video games. It's going to rot your brain. Well, guess what, Dad? I'm on the Xbox podcast now. Take that.
Guess what, Dad? I've still never read a book.
Don't tell him. He's watching the show. Oops. She's lying.
Yeah, you know what? That reminds me, Kelly. Thank you, Brian. I think we need to have a... There is a guest.
Yeah!
I think we need to have a... Maybe we should have a reading test to get on the show.
Gladly. You know what they... On TikTok, you can go and look up teleprompter videos on TikTok where they, like, pretend like it's a teleprompter and have you read. I guarantee you I will be I'm the number one teleprompter reader in the world. Not even on this show, in the world.
I'll battle you. I'll do that battle.
Yeah, and I'll probably lose to you. I'll lose to both of you.
No, it's fine. Anyway, we got a little bit more news here, but we're kind of closing in on the hour here. We were going to play some games. We had so much news and so much grimacing.
We're just catching up. We're just, you know, that's it.
Now, I want to talk about, this is really exciting, okay? Yeah. It's kind of a pink shirt, but tell us about Barbie.
All right. Barbie. So the really cool thing, I just want to give, before I get into this, we've done it before, but I want to give a shout out to the Xbox partnerships team. They have been killing it recently with the partnerships that, you know, we've seen Mandalorian earlier this year.
We had Oreos,
which, right, I still haven't got mine. So you don't. I mean, you had.
Well, next time you come in the office, okay, I've got a sleeve for you.
Perfect. We did OPI earlier this year as well. The newest one is with Barbie. This went absolutely viral on the internet earlier this week, where we announced the Barbie Series S console. But it wasn't just a pink console with the Barbie logo on it. It was a whole thing. It was
the Barbie Dream House.
It was Barbie's Dream House.
Which now I can't judge for you, Malik, because whatever.
Yeah.
I didn't play Barbie's Dream House when I was younger, but my two sisters did. No. I don't know. Did you? Now, Kelly?
Yeah.
Yeah, what? Did you have one?
Yeah. No, I didn't have a Barbie's Dream House.
Did you have the camper?
No, but I did have, like, the individual Barbies. I didn't really do a lot of the, like the bigger, like, houses and stuff like that. But I did have, Barbie had a little sister, Kelly, so yeah. I had a lot of the little Kelly dolls.
Your name is Kelly.
Yeah, but I used to steal my brother's, you know, that, like, Fisher Price castle. It was like a gray castle with, like, a little, like, drawbridge.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
I used to steal that and I would put my Barbies in it. So they had a Barbie's Dream Castle.
I love that. That's awesome.
Yeah. So big Barbie fan.
Barbie.
But I think the cool thing about this, well, of course, it's in relation to the movie coming out on July 21st. But the console that I don't believe, it's not for sale, obviously. I think it's going to be auctioned off. But you have the Barbie Dream House where the Series S sits in, as you can see on
right
screen
there.
Now.
That's actually cool. A Series S at the bottom there.
Absolutely.
Barbie.
And then you have the controller by one of our third-party hardware partners with 4 interchangeable plates that are designed after... costumes. You heard that. What was that?
Yeah.
I don't know.
There's a mouse in here.
Exactly. 4 faceplates for the controller that you can interchange that are designed after both Barbie and Ken's outfits in the game. And so that's a really cool thing. And people were like, I want to buy this. It's not for sale. But the next best thing might happen on July 14th. So if you're excited for the movie that's coming out, again, July 21st, on July 14th, we are going to be doing a very special stream right here on twitch.tv/Xbox from the world of Barbie in Malibu, California.
Have fun.
Malibu. Hosted by yours truly. And let me tell you something.
Because when you think Barbie, You think no. Malik?
Well, let me tell you something. Oh. I'm not going to say that I'm a Barbie guy. I've never played with Barbies, but I will say Ken's fashion is on point, and so we're going to be at the World of Barbie, and it's going to be an exciting stream. We're going to play Forza Motorsport, or Forza Horizon. Which,
because there's a Barbie car in.
Yeah, I think we have a picture of it. We have a Hummer, I believe. A Hummer. I hope I'm right. Yes.
Ooh.
I was like, don't get the manufacturer wrong. Yeah.
Corvette-ish kind of car.
The Barbie plate.
Which is amazing. Like, so you can drive both Ken and Barbie's car in Forza Horizon 5 right now. And so as you get ready for Barbie, if you want to really get into the mood, get into the character, you can go and download that right now and race and show off to all your friends. But on July 14th, we're going to be streaming from the World of Barbie. It is going to be fun.
Right here.
Right here on twitch.tv/Xbox.
Right here.
Now, I need you all to just help a little bit because I don't know what I'm going to wear. I can't wear... I'm a big fan of gray shirts. I can't just wear a gray shirt.
Yeah.
Do you need to use my wardrobe? I got a lot of pink.
I need your opinions on what to wear.
All right, come on over.
So give me those.
I think you and I are different size, but we can figure it out.
If you get me a Barbie controller,
okay,
I will take you on a shopping spree. Like, have you seen, speaking of Ken, Crazy Stupid Love?
Never heard of it.
Okay, well, it's a movie and the same.
Is it a book too?
Maybe.
Maybe I can read it.
But the actor, Ryan Gosling, is in both Barbie and that movie, and he takes Steve Carell on, like, a shopping spree and gives him a whole makeover look.
Okay.
So, yeah, I'll be your Sherpa.
I love that, and that's what I need. And so, but it's funny that you mentioned that not only you were talking a little bit earlier about your kind of Barbie collection. There are, I think we have a picture of it, too, but as a part of this, we worked with Mattel on, like, I think it's like 10, I don't know how many, but very specific Barbie dolls, because a big thing with Barbie is that, and here you see it right now, is representation, because for a long time, Barbie was seen as a girl's toy, or, you know, there was a certain kind of Barbie. I think what you see here are Barbies that were designed specifically for Xbox and Mattel. They're, again, not for sale, but we will be showcasing some of these on that stream, and so if you want to check it out, again, Barbie's come a long way. You see, you have a prosthetic leg there, Barbie in a wheelchair, both men, women, people of all different colors and shades. And so it's just a really cool partnership. And I think that's been the really cool thing about the partnerships team is how they have been not only working with these brands, but ensuring that representation is a part of it. And so it's cool.
Thank you very much for updating Barbie. We'll have more Barbie as we get through. We're getting into July's last day of June right now. It's June 30th.
That's right.
So my rent's due tomorrow.
We're headed. Your rent is due. Your rent is due.
Same.
We're going to, but yeah, we're looking forward to seeing that. I'll tune into that. And I know, you know, you'll tune into that as well, right, Kelly?
Yeah.
That's
1,000% with my Barbie controller Malik's going to get me.
That's right.
I'll just have on my Xbox
and
on over to the stream.
I got you.
Speaking of controllers, we've got these great the Starfield controller and headset. Do you want to pick those up and show those off, Kelly?
Yeah.
Put the headset on if you want. We got these. Now
Headset-ception.
That's kind of the headset-ception.
Headset-ception.
We've got the headset. We've got the controller, which Kelly's going to show off in a second. Now this is... Wow.
Divine.
Wow. Okay.
That was long.
I don't know what that was, but here it is. We're giving this away, and I'm going to give this away on Free Code Friday at hashtag Xbox Free Code Friday over on my Twitter. You can follow me on Twitter at Major Nelson. I'm going to give those away, as well as a copy of AEW Fight Forever, which is this new fighting game that's out. We talked about it a little bit earlier. It's got arcade feel. It's got a battle royale mode. You can pick up and play. If you like wrestling, AEW has your cover because you can do your customization, and this game just goes on forever. So it's a release on June 29th, which is yesterday. Across PC. AEW Fight Forever has arcade feel. It's got battle royale, and it's got all this other stuff. So we're gonna give away codes for that later on today on my Twitter, as well as the Starfield control. Not this, but it will be packaged.
So I haven't seen this, but it's so cool. I will say, you know, a lot of people love WWE and maybe haven't gone over into the AEW side, but I highly recommend it if you are fans of some of the older school wrestling games like WWF WrestleMania 2000 and WWF No Mercy, some of the best wrestling games of all time. This one is very much like that, as Larry mentioned, a more arcade feel. And so give it a shot. It's out now. And so are these, that controller and that headset, which, can I check out that controller?
Yeah. I haven't seen it. By the way, the headset, Kelly, it's not, I know we talked about this and we revealed it, but the headset, when you turn it on, it makes sounds from the game.
Oh. So, like, very cool.
Sounds.
Yeah.
You'll hear that in the game.
I love that.
And of course, the Easter egg, as a lot of our
controllers. Not anymore.
Yeah, not anymore. Somebody else posted it on Twitter, but inside of the battery case, you can't read it, but I'll read it for you. It says, "For all into the Starfield." So get ready, September 1st, September 6th, but, you know, get early access September 1st, you know.
Yeah.
So excited for it.
There's your fall.
Yeah. Also, mark your calendars. My birthday is September 12th.
So. Oh, okay.
Kelly. No, you can't do that.
That's exciting.
You know, hopefully that's not your birthday. You don't never give out your birthday.
Oh, it's on my Twitter.
Okay, well, never mind then. Anyway, so we've got, I think we're going to wrap things up here. We're going to play some games, but you know what? I think I hear Malik's tummy growling.
Oh, well, yeah.
Growling for a grimace shake.
No, thank you. No, thank you. So, yeah, weekend plans. We talked about this a little bit.
I'm gonna be going out on the water here in Lake Washington with some fireworks in the area. What about you, Kelly?
Yeah, I have some plans with friends, a little cookout. But me and old man Jack.
Little puppy.
Yeah, little dog. He doesn't like fireworks too much, so we tend to stay home a little bit.
Most animals don't.
So we'll be home early, and just going to chill. We were talking about this, but the post-E3 exhaustion is still real. Like, it was so fun doing FanFest and getting to meet people, but it was like busy.
Well, I think it's you know, that's certainly a lot of work, but what people don't see, I mean, they kind of feel it because we talk about it, but, you know, we're starting... Like, especially you, Kelly, because you work directly on some of the titles, you start working on those months ago, like at the beginning of the year. So it's like this constant to meet the deadlines. And now it's like you can exhale finally, right?
Yeah, the fear that, like, oh, it's going to leak or something's going to happen or the trailer isn't going to be ready or people are going to hate it or, like, there's just so much. And then all of a sudden, like, it's out in the world. And I tweeted this, but it's so surreal when you work on something for years and you're like
in private.
And you can't talk about it, even like not using the code name and using the actual name of the game is like you start hearing people say and you're like everybody so it's, you know, getting used to that and then pivoting to what's next, because, you know, working games never
more start. games. Anyway, Malik, what about you?
You know, it's going to be a classic Malik weekend, as people have already pointed out.
You're going to sit down and read a book?
Friday night, absolutely not, Larry. No books for me. But Friday night, we eat well. We eat good, as they say. Poor grammatics, but we eat good on Friday nights with tons of fast food. And then Saturday night, we do the same. And then we round out the weekend with a little bit of broccoli on Sunday night to pay for the sins. But sleeping all week.
Question.
Yeah.
You used a lot of we there. Who's this we?
Oh, that's just the royal we. You know, it's for the people who vibe with me, you know, who are just like, let's...
It's him in his vacuum.
Yeah, Brooklyn the vacuum. And Gunner. Gunner's there. Well, Gunner's there. I try not to give him... He got an upset tummy. He's older.
Your dog, right?
Okay. Yes.
Yep. Yeah, listen, if you want to follow us on Twitter, I don't know if we can get that box coming up here, Alex, with all our Twitters on the bottom. But we've got... you can follow me at Major Nelson. We're going to be doing free code, Xbox free code Friday later on. Kelly at Kello Lombardo, whatever that is. Kello.
That's my name.
I know.
Kel Lombardi.
Kel
Lombardi.
There's no I. Or Y.
I see.
Yeah, because it's just one thing.
I know. See what it is. That's what I was doing. Yeah.
I never got why there was...
Kelly Lombardi is taken.
Ah.
Kelly, like, it's just, yeah, so.
I like, that's clever.
Kello. Kel Lombardi.
And then, of course, at Malik Prince for all of your...
my name.
You know, if you want to check out his Goodreads list. Anyway, I'm going to keep going on.
I love it.
He did it to himself. There's not really
I did. Doing. And you know what? I welcome it still.
Yeah.
Anyway, is that one of your... Oh, that's... I was going to say, that's the bot dropping it in the chat. So you're telling us... Kelly's... Oh, that's not okay.
Xbox has tried to prove that they're not a bot this entire stream, right. And then you just called them a bot, so...
and told me I'm not a bot. Anyway.
Xbox is not a bot.
Hey, you know what? It's 12 noon on the West Coast. It's 3 o'clock on the East Coast. It's top of the hour wherever you are. So thank you guys for hanging out with us for the past 60 minutes. Check out my Twitter right now. Free Code Friday is going to begin any moment. We're going to give away a Starfield controller as well as some copies of this new wrestling game, AEW Fight Forever. So check that out. What do you guys
think? It's like the Korean heart.
Oh, yeah, the little. Yeah. Right.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for joining us, you two. Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us.
And thank you at home. So we'll see you next week. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.